Hello everyone and welcome back to another easy PowerPoint animation tutorial. And in this video we are going to create this short shoe animation that can be used for explainer videos. So this animation is inspired by one of the animations by Valentin Kirillov at dribble.com, and the link of this page has been given in the video description. And we would also like to thank all our patrons for their continuous support. And if you also want to support us, then you can find the Patreon link in the video description, or you can also give us a thanks. So let's get back to the presentation. And here we have used total 9 slides to create this animation. And first of all, we will see that which animation effects has been used in this presentation. And for that, I will go to the animations tab and will click on the animation pan. And here you can see that we have used a few animation effects on the first slide, but if you move to the second slide, then you will see that there is no animation effect on this slide. And so if we move forward to the next slide, then you can see that we have not used any animation effect from second to eighth slide. Then on the ninth slide, you will again find one of the animation effects. So how basically we have drawn this shoe here and which animation effect we have used, that is what this tutorial is about. So let's get started. So if we move back to the first slide, then let me show you the design here first. You can download this presentation for free and the link to the PPT is given in the video description. And after downloading and opening the presentation, if you select all the objects of this first slide by either going to the home tab and then click select drop down button and then choose select all, or you can also press Ctrl A key to select all the objects on this slide. After that you should go to the shape format and here you should choose shape fill and then choose no fill, and then again go to shape outline and here choose black outline. So that way you can see that which shapes has been used to draw the shoe. And you can also take the help of selection pane from the home tab. You can open the selection pane from the select drop down button and then click selection pane. And you can also note down that which object has been placed on which position, like which object is on front and which object is on back. So let's talk about the shapes here. So shoe sole, we have used the rectangle shape like this. And then we use another shape, rectangle shape, to draw this stripe here like this. And then we align the shape to the middle, like I will select the larger rectangle first and then the shorter rectangle, and then go to shape format, then click align and then choose align middle. For this part of the shoe I use the freeform shape, and I have already taught many times that how you should use this freeform shape tool. So if you will continue click, then it will work like a pencil, and you have to double click to close the points. And the another way to use freeform shape is to the freeform shape, and then you just need to click once, then move the mouse pointer where you want to add the second point, and then click, and then move again forward, then click again, then click again, and then you have to join them together. Once you have a rough shape, then you can use the add shape edit points command to adjust the points. Like I want to adjust the shape like this. I want to give a curve right from this point, and I want to make it straight like this. So then later you can choose the colors, fill colors, and can remove the outlines. Now I can send this shape back, send to back, and I can choose a different color for this. Let's say I choose a gray color for this and remove the outline, and let it be blue but remove the outline. And then again to draw this part of the shoe, I again use the freeform shape like this. First point here, then the second point here, then the third point, fourth point, fifth point, and then join together, and later use the edit shape, edit point command, and before that you can choose no fill, so you can see only the outline, and you can also choose a different color for the outline so you may see it clearly while editing points. Sorry, select the shape, go to edit shape, edit points, and now I can give a curve here like this. So that way I have designed this shoes here. So let me undo all of this. So if I see the slideshow, then you can see that all the slides, all the 9 slides are running one by one according to the time specified under the transitions tab. So I will show you that, but before that I will also like to show you the presenter view of this PPT, and for that I will switch the presenter view to this first monitor. I have installed 2 monitors on my computer, so I will swap to presenter view, and here you can see that how the slides are moving forward. So that is very important part, that for how much time it is standing on the first slide, then moving forward to the second, third, fourth and eighth slide, then on the eighth slide it stops for 1 second and then again move to the 9th slide. So that way you can have a rough guess that how the animation is working, and here it is recording the timing, but I don't want to record any timing, so I will press the escape key to close this presenter view, or I can swap between the presenter and slideshow view from this display setting drop down menu like this. So I will press the escape key to go back to the presentation, and here on the first slide now we will discuss about the animation effects. If you look into the animation pane, then you can see that the first 5 animations are similar, and if you hover your mouse over it, then you can see that the stretch animation effect has been used, and all these animations has been set to play with previous. If I move to the animations tab, then you can see that it is set to with previous, and all these animations are set to play with previous. The benefit of setting the animation effects to play with previous, later you can adjust the delay timings between the effects according to your requirement. Like you can give a very short delay timing as required. Like you can see the difference between the delay timing in these following effects. And there is only 0.05 seconds delay difference between each of these effects. So if I select this rectangle, then you can see that we have used the stretch animation effect on this object. So if I double click on this effect, then you can see the direction is set to across under the settings. You can also see the effect options by clicking on this effect options drop down menu, and you can also change the direction right from here. And if I move to the timings tab, then you can see with previous is set and delay timing is 1 second, and duration of this animation effect is 0.5 seconds. So if we move forward, and if I select this stripe here, then you can see that we have again used the stretch animation effect, and the delay timing is 1.50 seconds and the duration is same, and this time we have used from right traction, and same has been done for this this part of the shoe and for this part of the shoe. You can open this presentation and can double click on the animation effects to see that which timings and effect options has been used. Do remember that the animation pan highlights all the animation effect of the selected object on the slide. So that way you can easily understand that which animation effects has been used on which object. And that is the 5th object on which we have used the stretch animation effect. During the slideshow, you can see that how those holes are popping out, and also the shoelaces are popping out, and then we have another part here which is coming out. So for the holes in the shoes, we have used the basic zoom animation effect, and you can find all these entrance animation effect. The green icon here indicates that the entrance animation effect has been used, and you can find all the entrance animation effects from the add animation drop down button, and here you can find more entrance effect, and here you can see the stretch animation effect and the basic zoom animation effect. So on all these dots we have used the basic zoom animation effect. The only difference is the delay timing. So for this oval 20 you can see the delay timing is 1.80, and for this oval 23 we have set the delay timing to 1.95 seconds, and the timing difference between these two effects is only 0.15 seconds. And for these four shoelaces we have also used the basic zoom animation effect. But from the second to eighth slide, if you move through these slides by using the down arrow key, then you can see that there is no animation effect has been applied on these slides. So why this slide has been added? So after creating the first slide, we duplicated the same by right clicking on it in the thumbnail view and then choose duplicate slide. And on the second slide, like you can see here on the third slide, we just changed the position of this shoelace. We have increased the size like this, and then we also rotated it like this, and then moved the position like this. So on the second slide we are not applying any animation effect. So on the third slide we just again move the position of this shoelace, and we are doing the same on each duplicated slide. Like on the first slide you will not see this part, but on the second slide you can see that it is coming out, and we start changing the position of both of these objects here. Then again on the fifth slide we moved them a little bit more and did the same on sixth, seventh and eighth slide. On the ninth slide we used the motion path animation effect, and we used the left motion path, and let me delete this animation effect. And you can apply the motion path from the add animations drop down button and then choose more motion path, and here you can find the left motion path. Hit the OK key, then you can increase the length of the path by holding the shift key. Holding the shift key will move the path in a straight line. And after that I will set it to play with previous, double click it to configure the effect option properties. I want to start it smoothly but end fast, so I will adjust the timings here, like 0.50 for start smoothness. Hit the OK key. And lastly you need to configure the slide timing for each of the slide, and you can do this by moving to the transitions tab, and here you need to uncheck this option on mouse click, then make a check mark on after and apply the timings as required for each of the slides. So on the first slide we have used a slide timing of 2.70 seconds because our last animation effects end at 2.70 if you hover your mouse at it. And from the second to eighth slide, if you see, then we have used a very short timing of 0.10 seconds for all these slides from second to eighth. So during the slideshow, it will show you the second to eighth slide in just 0.70 seconds. So when in that short time, the seventh slide will move, then it will create an animation like this. So when you will run the slideshow and the slides will move in a very short period, then it creates a nice animation effect. If you use the arrow up and down arrow keys and move between the slides in the thumbnail view, then it will also create an animation effect like this. And on the ninth slide, it will move to the left using the motion path. So let me run the slideshow. So I have set to loop this animation effect, and you can do this by moving to the slideshow tab, like slideshow tab, and here click on setup slideshow and make a check mark on loop continuously until escape. And we should also check the slide timing of the last slide, and that is set to 2 seconds according to the animation effect length. So after all these, if you run the slideshow, then it will run in a continuous loop. I hope this tutorial will help you to learn a few more new things. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video. And you can also subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks a lot for watching and for your time. Bye and take care.